Good morning, students. Now we will discuss another anatomy of another organ, that is transverse section of dicots. So for best study, that is transverse section of stem of sunflower. A transverse section of dicot stem has various tissues, one above the other. So they are, and this is the ground plane of transverse section of dicot stem. If you magnify this portion, then this portion appeared like this. So this portion has different tissues, one above the other, or they are arranged concentrically. And the transverse section of dicot stem has various tissues. The outermost tissue is, this is epidermis. So what is epidermis? Already I told you, it is the outermost layer. It is the outermost protective layer. And this epidermis is unilayer. And the epidermis is made up of elongated and compactly arranged parenchymata cells. And these parenchymata cells have narrow cytoplasm and centrally located vacuole. And in some cases, the epidermis also possesses stomata. If it is young stem, then the epidermis possesses stomata. Then stomata helps in exchange of gases. And some of the epidermal cells possesses trichomes. Trichomes are also called stem hairs. And these trichomes are unicellular or multicellular, maybe branched or unbranched, or loose or stiff. And these trichomes present on some of the epidermal cells. And the outer side, the epidermis also possesses a cuticle layer. A cutin present in the form of cuticle. And this cuticle and these trichomes, a cuticle and trichomes, they reduce the rate of transpiration. What is transpiration? It is the loss of water in the form of vapor, that is called transpiration. Cuticle and trichomes, these two reduce the rate of transpiration. And the second tissue is hypodermis. And this is this layer, and this layer is called hypodermis. In dicot stem, the hypodermis is made up of collenchyma. It is very important point. And collenchymata cells, one to few layer of collenchymata cells present below the epidermis is called hypodermis. So hypodermis, already I told you, in dicot stem, collenchyma present in the form of hypodermis below epidermis. And if hypodermis is made up of collenchyma, then its function is to provide mechanical support to various plant organs. So hypodermis or collenchymata cells provides mechanical strength to dicot stem. And below the hypodermis, so few to many layered parenchymata cells present, and this tissue is known as general cortex. So what is general cortex? Few to many layered parenchymata cells present below the hypodermis is known as general cortex. And general cortical cells, usually it is made up of parenchyma. Then parenchyma cells have intercellular spaces. And some of the cells also possesses chloroplast. If they possesses chloroplast, then they also helps in synthesis of food material. But usually it helps in slow conduction of water, minerals and food material. And next one, endodermis. So endodermis is the innermost layer of cortex. This region is known as cortex. From hypodermis to endodermis. From hypodermis to endodermis, this region is known as cortex. From pericycle to this region, this entire region is known as stele. And what is endodermis? It is the innermost layer of cortex. Endodermis is innermost layer of cortex, and it is usually unilayer. And the cells are barrel shaped. And in dicot stem, the endodermis is rich in starch grains. Due to presence of starch grains, the endodermis is also known as, in dicot stem, the endodermis is also known as starch sheath. In dicot and monocot roots, the endodermal cells contain suberin bands and casparian strips. Due to presence of suberin bands and casparian strips in roots, endodermis act as bridge. Or endodermis become impermeable for water and minerals between cortex and stellar region. Whereas in dicot stem, Casparian bands absent, Casparian strips absent on endodermis. Instead, endodermal cells contain large number of starch grains. So due to presence of large amount of starch grains, this endodermis act as starchy. Initially starch grains present. So after the utilization of starch grains, the function of the exact function of endodermis was not known. But it is the innermost layer and it helps in storage of starch grains. And in stems, usually the cortical region is smaller than stellar region. If you observe this diagram, ear to ear is still, from ear to ear is cortex. So obviously the stellar region is larger than cortical region. In stems, cortical region is larger than still. Whereas in stems, whether it is dicot or monocot, the stellar region is larger than cortical region. And this is the first tissue of steel. So what is the first outermost layer of steel? That is pericycle. So this is the pericycle. In dicot stem, the pericycle, in dicot stem, the pericycle usually made up of both parenchyma and sclerenchyma. Both parenchyma and sclerenchyma. If pericycle made up of both parenchyma and sclerenchyma, then the pericycle is called heterogeneous pericycle. Heterogeneous pericycle. If pericycle, entire pericycle is made up of only sclerenchyma, then it is known as homogeneous. But in dicot stem, if you observe the dicot, if you observe the transverse section of sunflower stem, then the pericycle is made up of, half of the pericycle made up of sclerenchyma and remaining half is made up of parenchyma. If the pericycle is made up of both parenchyma and sclerenchyma, then the pericycle is known as heterogeneous pericycle. In dicot stem, the sclerenchymatous pericycle present in semilunar patches. Semilunar patches of sclerenchymatous cells present below the endodermis is known as pericycle. Semilunar. This is one semilunar patch and this is another semilunar patch. And these semilunar patches made up of sclerenchyma. So semilunar patches of sclerenchymatous cells present below endodermis is known as pericycle. Then pericycle made up of which tissue? Sclerenchyma. Then what is the function of pericycle? Then pericycle obviously it gives mechanical support to the dicot stem. So next, vascular bundles. This is phloem, this is cambium. This structure is known as cambium. What is cambium? It is a fully mesenchymatic cell. And this is xylem. Phloem, xylem. This is cambium. In dicot stem, so this is phloem, this is cambium, and this is xylem. If phloem and xylem present together, if xylem and phloem present together, then the vascular bundles are called conjoint. Then both phloem and xylem, both phloem and xylem, they are present in same radius. If they are present in both same radius, then it is known as collateral. Then here cambium present between phloem and xylem. Phloem in between phloem and xylem, there is a cambium. If cambium present, then it is said to be open type. So in dicot stem, the vascular bundles are conjoint, collateral, open type of vascular bundles present. It is very, very, very important. So which type of vascular bundles present? Conjoint. Conjoint means both xylem, phloem present together. Collateral, both are in same radius. Open, cambium present between xylem and phloem. So conjoint, collateral, open type of vascular bundles present in only dicot stem. So due to presence of cambium, the secondary growth is possible in dicot stem. And here, this is the ground plane. If you observe the ground plane of dicot stem, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like 15 to 20 vascular bundles. From 15 to 20 vascular bundles present in a ring form. And this type of arrangement is known as U-steel arrangement. In dicot stem, the arrangement of vascular bundles is known as U-steel. So what is U-steel? The ring arrangement of 15 to 20 vascular bundles. The ring arrangement of 15 to 20 vascular bundles in dicot stem is known as eustelic vascular bundles. It is also very important point. Eustelic secondary growth is possible in only eustelic plants. Eustelic means 15 to 20 vascular bundles present in a ring form, and this ring arrangement is known as eustelic. Here secondary growth possible due to presence of cambium. What is cambium? It is a fully mesenchymatic tissue. The mesenchymatic tissue always divide to produce large number of cells. When large number of cells are newly formed, cells are added to that particular region and automatically girth or width is increased. Increase in girth or increase in width, that is nothing but secondary growth. So here how many vascular bundles present? 15 to 20 vascular bundles present in a ring, and this ring arrangement is known as eustelic. And here the position of primary xylem, this is metaxylem and this is protoxylem. Metaxylem towards pericycle and protoxylem towards medulla. If metaxylem towards pericycle and protoxylem towards medulla, then the position of primary xylem is known as endarch. Endarch type of primary xylem is the characteristic feature of stems, whether it is dicot or monocot. The position of primary xylem is endarch position. Endarch position means metaxylem towards outer and protoxylem towards inner. And next tissue is medulla, and this is the medulla. So what is the medulla? It is the centrally located parenchymatous cells. A centrally located parenchymatous cells is known as medulla, or medulla is also known as pith. And a large amount of medulla present, the large amount of medulla present at center of the dicot stem and is known as medulla. So medulla is only made up of parenchymatous cells. If it is made up of parenchymatous cells, then what is its function? So obviously it helps in slow conduction of water, minerals and food material from cortex to stellar region and vice versa. And one more important thing is medullary rays. In dicot stem, medullary rays are also present, and the medullary rays, it is the tissue of ground tissue system. Medullary rays present only in dicot stem. Medullary rays present only in dicot stem, and medullary rays absent in roots, monocot stem and leaves. And what are medullary rays? Elongated parenchymatous cells. Elongated parenchymatous cells present between adjacent vascular bundles. This is one vascular bundle. If you observe ground plane, this is one vascular bundle and this is another vascular bundle. In between these two vascular bundles, like some of the elongated parenchymatous cells are present. And these elongated parenchymatous cells are called, these elongated parenchymatous cells between adjacent vascular bundles is known as medullary rays. And medullary rays connects steel with cortex region for lateral conduction of water, minerals and organic materials. So these are the various tissues concentrically arranged in dicot stem. And all these tissues observed, the observation is possible when you observe the transverse section of, when the dicot stem is transversely sexed and observed under electron microscope, then all the tissues are clearly visible. So these are the internal tissue organization of TS of dicot stem. So for study of transverse section of dicot stem, the stem of sunflower is better convenient.